Napoleon lived a short but eventful life, full of war and dictatorship, which ultimately led to his death in the year 1821.
Napoleon was born on August 15th in Corsica, Italy. When he turned 9 years old, he moved to the French mainland and enrolled at a religious school in Auden in January of that year. In May of that same year, he transferred with a scholarship to the military academy at Brenais-la-Chatre.
In 1785, on October 28th, Napoleon graduated from École Militaire with the rank of the second lieutenant in the artillery. November 3rd, he was stationed in Valence.
On December 22nd, 1793, for his brilliant tactical command, although a subordinate officer, he was widely credited for the victory. At an internal French battle at Toulon, Napoleon receives the new rank of Brigadier General.
In political power in France, he crowned himself emperor in 1804. Since he had total control of France, he quickly rose military power and became one of the most ambitious military leaders in the history of France. His first act was to wage a civil war on certain coalitions and on European nations to expand his empire.
His first major accomplishment was at the Battle of Austerlitz, in which his army successfully defeated the Austrians and the Russians, which upset the Holy Roman Empire and formed Greater Confederation in the Rhine River area.
He continued his tyranny across Europe by establishing a blockade to seize all British trade and eventually wither their economy. His strategy proved to be very effective and forced Alexander I to sign a peace treaty.
This was a very successful period for Napoleon, and he began to reestablish a French aristocracy and began handing out titles of honor and nobility to friends and family.
Every attack Napoleon led, the Russians retreated. This led Napoleon deeper into the harsh climate of Russia. Both sides suffered great losses, which forced Napoleon to march into Moscow, only to find the entire city to have been evacuated. Napoleon became enraged and burned multiple cities across Russia, starting with Moscow.
Charge!
When he returned to France in 1814, he was forced to abdicate his throne and was exiled to a Mediterranean island off the coast of Italy. His abdication came soon to an end in less than a year. On February 26, 1815, he fled the island along with 1,000 supporters. When he reached France in March, he was welcomed by the crowds and the current king fled, making Napoleon king once again. France's allies did not like him returning and prepared to launch a group attack. Luckily, Napoleon found out and took them out before they could react. Although he began to dominate once more, his ambitions led to a devastating defeat at the Battle of Waterloo, and once again, he was a defeat.
Your disappointment, Napoleon.
Now be gone!
Come here! I said no, come here!
Why?
Napoleon never returned to France, and soon he died on the island of St. Helena. He died on May 5th, 1821, due to stomach cancer.
It's my time now.
Are you going?
Yeah.
The French are aristocracy. I can't say it.
Can I take your spot?
No, I got this.
First major accomplishment was at the Battle.
No.
Every attack, Napoleon led the Russians retreated. This led Napoleon.
You!
No!
Napoleon.